John Henry's pappy woke him up one midnight. He said, "Before the sheriff comes, I want to tell you, listen, boy." Said, "Learn to ball a jack, learn to lay a track, learn to pick and shovel too, and take my hammer, it'll do anything you tell it to." John Henry's mammy had about a dozen babies. John Henry's pappy broke tail about a dozen times. The babies all got sick, and when the doctor wanted money, he said, "I'll pay you a quarter at a time. Start tomorrow. That's a pay for a steel driver on his line." Then the section foreman said, "Hey, hammer swinger, I see you brought your own hammer, boy, but what else can all them muscles do?" And he said, "I can turn a jack, I can lay a track, I can pick and shovel too.
Can you swing a hammer, boy?"
"Yes, sir, I'll do anything you hire me to."
"Now, ain't you something so high and mighty with your muscle? Just go ahead, boy, and pick up that hammer. Pick up the hammer."
He said, "Get a rusty spike and swing it down three times. I'll pay you a nickel a day for every inch you sink it to. Go on and do what you say you can do." With a steep-nosed hammer on a four-foot switch handle, John Henry raised it back till it touched his heels. And the spike went through the cross tie and it split it half in two. 35 cents pay for driving steel.
"Sweat! Sweat, boy! Sweat! You owe me two more swings."
"I was born for driving steel." Well, John Henry hammered in the mountain. He'd give a grunt, he'd give a groan with every swing. The women folks for miles around heard him and come down to watch him make the cold steel ring. Lord, what a swinger! Just listen to that cold steel ring. But the bad boss come up laughing at John Henry. Said, "You full of vinegar now, but you bout through. We gonna get a steam drill to do your share driving. Then what's all them muscles gonna do, huh, John Henry? Gonna take a little bit of vinegar out of you." John Henry said, "I feed four little brothers and baby sisters walking on her knees. Did the Lord say that machines ought to take the place of living? And what's a substitute for bread and beans? I ain't seen it. Do engines get rewarded for their steam?" John Henry hid in a coal mine for his dinner nap. Had 30 minutes to rest before the bell. The mine boss hollered, "Get up, whoever you are, and get a pickaxe. Give me enough coal to start another hell and keep it burning. Mine me enough to start another hell." John Henry said to his captain, "A man ain't nothing but a man. But if you bring that steam drill around, I'll beat it fair and honest. I'll die with my hammer in my hand, but I'll be laughing, 'cause you can't replace a steel driving man." There was a big crowd of people at the mountain. John Henry said to the steam drill, "How is you?" "Pardon me, Mr. Steam Drill, I suppose you didn't hear me. I said, how you? Huh? Well, can you turn a jack? Can you lay a track? Can you pick and shovel too? Listen to
hammer swingers talking to you.
Threw his hammer over his shoulder and went on home. He lay down to rest his weary back, and early next morning he said, "Come here, Polly Ann. Come here, sugar. You know, I believe this is the first time I ever watched the sun come up that I couldn't come up. Take my hammer, Polly Ann, and go to that railroad. Swing that hammer like you seen me do it. And when you're swinging with the lead man, they'll all know. They'll all know you're John Henry's woman, but tell them that ain't all you can do. Tell them, I can hoist a jack, and I can lay a track. I can pick and shovel, too. Ain't no machine can. That's been proved to you."
There was a big crowd of mourners at the church house. Section hands laid him in the sand. Trains go by on the rails John Henry laid.
They slow down, they take off the hats, the men do, when they come to the place where John Henry's laying, resting his back. Some of them say, "Morning, steel driver. You sure was a hammer swinger." Then they go on by, picking up a little speed. Clickety-clack, 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 clickety-clack.
John lies a steel driving man, oh Lord.